I think a scientist has to have a desire to discover something. If you're in biology, you want to figure out how life works. That's essentially what biology is. How do living things really work? So take that curiosity and translate it into some method of discovering something. I was just interested in the natural world, you know. I really don't know where that curiosity came from, but it formed my education. I was just curious about things, and I would grow flowers, and I would look at stars, and anything around me I was paying attention to. And that didn't come with formal training, that came with curiosity. The favorite part of my work is the field work and the diving. That's really what got me into this. I love to dive. I'd love to be in the underwater world, totally immersed in it, to see how animals are behaving under natural conditions. So I have study sites currently literally around the globe. When I'm diving, that's where I get my most inspiration and my best questions come out, when I'm immersed in that environment. So diving is clearly my favorite thing in my branch of science, followed by laboratory experimentation. And that's really key, because now you control things in the laboratory. In the field, you're not in any kind of control. You're in the animal's world. In a laboratory, we turn that around and we can control the environment, cut down the variables some more, and address very specific things.
It was pretty clear to me from an early age that engineering technologies were where my heart was. I've always really had a passion for this. My students and I look at the problems of making unmanned vehicles and robots smarter. In particular, we look at these algorithmic challenges of sensing, perception, decision-making to make these vehicles more autonomous.
So the main way it senses the environment is through this sensor, which is called a LiDAR.
The vast majority of science and engineering happens as part of a big team. And so you have to know how to work well with others. You have to know how to lead a team. You have to know how to be part of a team. And you have to know how to get people to come with you in pursuit of your vision. You cannot be a good engineer and not be a good communicator. Even with the best ideas in the world, if you don't know how to tell the world, then nobody's going to understand. And if the name of the game is impact, you will have no impact. Science and engineering are really rewarding in lots of ways, but they're also tough in some ways. Mother Nature is tough to go battle against sometimes. And the great tragedy of science is sometimes the world just doesn't work the way you want and you gotta figure it out. There are problems I've chosen not to work on just because life is short and you can't do everything and you gotta play to your strengths. I've had the good fortune to have phenomenally talented students and the good fortune to pick really interesting problems, and I've loved working on all of them.